Welcome back, my name is Dwight and this is GeForce Garage. In our first four episodes of our Scratch Build series, we designed a chassis in SketchUp. Then we picked up some basic metal fabrication techniques. Next, we learned how to paint a complex design using hydro dipping. And then we shined up some of our components using brushed, polished, and hammered finishes. Now, we're gonna be modding the centerpiece of our Scratch Build, the GTX 1080 Ti. Today we got master modder Ron Lee Christensen of Blue Horse Studios to help us level up our video cards. Hey Ron, how you doing?
Great, it's great to be back.
Yeah, glad to have you back.
Thank you.
Okay, so you've painted a lot of video cards in the day. Mm-hmm. We have four of them here. Can you tell us a little bit about them?
Yeah, this is one that we did kind of in a blue rustic tone, and this one here with the same effect, but rust and kind of gray and white. Mm-hmm. And then these two down here are Star Wars ones. We did this one for the BB-8 build. Did some fading and gradient battle damage to match BB-8's armor. And the last one down here is the Shore Trooper build that we did for the release of the recent Star Wars movie. And to kick it up a bit, you can also go ahead and paint the backplate. And this pattern matches the Shore Trooper's armor.
Yeah, and all the new ones come with backplates, so it just gives you another canvas to kind of work on.
Yeah, it's just a great way to, you know, personalize and customize your PC and, you know, painting one of them is probably the simplest and easiest way to do that.
All right, well, we have our GTX 1080 Ti here, and you're going to show us how to mod our own for our Scratch Build today.
Yeah, it's going to be a fun, easy process. To do a simple paint job like this, it involves a couple hours every day. So we'll go through all that with you guys today and how to do that.
All right, cool. Well, let's crack this open and get to painting.
All right, let's do it.
All right, Ron, so I've taken apart a lot of GPUs in my time. Mm-hmm. You know, done a lot of water cooling and stuff like that, so I know how to take them apart and stuff, but I know that you can't just take the video card, put it down, and spray paint away. So what's your first step?
First step is you want to test the card, make sure it works before you take it apart. Check with your warranty, see if it's covered if you do take the card apart, because you could void the warranty. So there's three steps to taking the card apart. You want to take the back plate, the PCB off, the shroud, and then you have some interior pieces like the fan and stuff and the LED. So all those pieces need to come apart, be separated, all the screws organized. So when you put it back together, you just follow the reverse order.
Okay, and I notice you have three containers over here. Is that for the three steps that we're gonna be doing?
Those are for the screws that we're gonna take the card apart, and we're gonna place the screws in an order so we don't misplace the screws and where they go. So the first container is gonna be for the back plate and the PCB. The second is gonna be for the interior of the card. The shroud, back plate, number three is gonna be for the fan and the LEDs and stuff like that.
So I know you need more than just a screwdriver. So what other tools did you bring?
Well, we do have a Phillips screwdriver. We have a 4mm socket head screwdriver and two hex key T-wrenches, 3/32 and a 5/64.
All right, cool. Well, let's get to taking apart a video card.
Let's do it. First thing we need to do is remove all these little tiny screws here and the four screws on top. So we're going to use our first container as we have labeled number one. You want to keep your screws in the correct order so when you go put it back together, you know exactly where they go. I think there's probably about 50 screws in total on this entire card. So moving on to the interior part of the card, I'm using my 4mm hex wrench here.
So we moved on from one to two since we're on the interior now.
So these are pretty tight on here.
Yeah, it's good to not just lift it, but rather wiggle it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So now that we've removed the PCB, there's two power connections on the card here. There's one for the LED that illuminates the GeForce logo on the front of the card and the other for the fan. So you want to remove these very delicately because you don't want to destroy the connection. So that one is there for the fan and this is for the LED. And now you have your PCB removed. Put this back in the anti-static bag. And we'll move to our little third container here. So this will be the interior of the card and the shroud. So there's a couple screws in here that are underneath the thermal pad that we need to remove. So I'm just gonna remove the thermal pad, set it aside, set it maybe on your anti-static bag.
And you wanna be careful with that because those can rip fairly easy.
Yeah,
so be gentle with them.
Exactly, and you wanna keep track of those because they are important. They do need to go on the heat spreaders. And there's three screws here that will remove the fan. What we need to do next is go ahead and start removing the shroud. There's a couple screws on the back here. So now we can go ahead and move on to our T-handle hex wrenches and start removing the shroud. And so I'll be using 3/32 for the larger ones. I think that's all the screws here. And then now it's back to the Phillips because...
Oh, there's actually screws underneath this piece.
Yep, that hold this part in, and this back part of the shroud won't come off until we remove this one. All right. That piece comes out, and then we have the LED in there, and then we're just gonna remove that as well. That's just stuck in there with a little bit of tape. Takes a little bit of force to pull it out, but. And then that part of the shroud is ready for paint once we get the body on that prepped. And then fan comes out as well because we already removed the screws there. Mm-hmm. And then we got two more Phillips heads to hold this the back part of the shroud. All right. And our card is completely disassembled.
Cool. So we are just going to be painting the silver pieces, right, for this build?
And the black piece as well, and the back plates. So we're going to start wet sanding here, and I have some 600 grit sandpaper. I've been soaking in a little bit of dishwater for about 20 minutes. And then we're just going to start lightly sanding our pieces. We don't need to take all the paint off. We just need to just give the pieces just a little bit of a teeth.
So is that it? That's all you got to do?
Yeah, then you just want to rinse it off. If you have an alcohol cloth too, like wet naps, you can take that extra step. But I just usually just wipe it off, just run it under some tap water and just set it aside and just let it dry. And once it's dry, you can go ahead and take it outside, or you know, if you have a ventilated area, a paint booth, you know, just spray your adhesion promoter. You let that adhesion promoter dry for a few minutes and then you're ready for first coats of paint.
Okay, well let's sand the rest of the pieces in.
All right.
All right, so we went outside and used our adhesion promoter on all of our parts, and we let it dry outside. But now that we're back indoors, we can get to painting.
Yeah. I use an airbrush for my setup, but you can use rattle can paint. It's probably the most economical for most people. We already have our two colors already pre-mixed, a little bit of aluminum, and I have a little bit of midnight blue, and a little bit of reducer to thin the paint down so it'll flow through my brush a little bit easier. So we're gonna start with the back piece here, and we're gonna start with blue. I'm just gonna go in super light coats. First coat is basically your tack coat. That's what all your other coats are gonna lay on top of. If I just go super wet, then it's just gonna drip right off.
So start really fine.
Yep.
And then you can go a little bit heavier on the next one.
Yep, exactly. Slowly want to just keep building up your layers until it's fully covered. You can start to see the pearl in the paint as the layers start to develop.
It's crazy that it just slightly gets darker every single time.
Yeah, I mean, you could just like blast it, but then it's not gonna adhere. It's just gonna roll off the surface for you.
Right.
So, you know, just light coats, very light coats. It can tend to be tedious, but just one of those things that you can't rush, you know. Mm-hmm. Paint dries in its own time. And that's the great thing about using water-based paint for me is the paint dries quickly, you know, versus using like an aerosol can. You're dealing with mostly enamel paints and
right.
They have a cure time on them. Sometimes it's 24 hours. Mm-hmm. Here I can add layers upon layers upon layers within minutes. So that piece is probably about 95% complete. When this fully dries, then I'll come back and kind of see any areas that I didn't hit and do like the backside and underneath side. Now we'll just set that aside. Go to the next piece, which is a little side skirt here for the GPU. The further away that you hold your airbrush, the wider pattern that's gonna give for you, and the less paint that's gonna actually attach to the surface. See, if you can see on the paper towel, you can see how light that goes on. Now, if I get down here, you can see how heavy. If I were to do that pattern right onto this, the paint wouldn't stick, it would just roll right off. So that's why I'm holding it so far away from the surface. Just want little coats at a time. All right, now that one is about 95% done. When that dries, I can be able to handle them, I can turn it over and see any areas that I missed. And we can move on to the next piece, which is gonna be the back plate. We just have to change the paint in our gun. Just remove the needle from the gun. Blow out any excess paint. Now there's gonna be a little bit of paint left in the nozzle head. What I like to do is just take a little bit of reducer, put it in my gun, and just back blow it. You can see the paint that's left in there.
Okay.
Blows it right back into the cup. And since that's good paint and good reducer, save it. Put it right back in my paint mix. So next color is our silver. All right, so now it's time to paint the back plate. So as I'm painting here, you can kind of notice that I'm going off the surface. I'm not just stopping right at the edge of the back plate. Kind of just overlapping a good couple inches. What this does is prevents from having a harsh line on your edge. And that one is pretty much done as well. We'll allow that to dry a little bit. All right, so our final piece here, I went ahead and taped off this area because underneath that is a nice brush aluminum that I don't want this color to come in contact with. And it's gonna make a nice contrast between the aluminum and silver. So I just taped it off to protect that. So that one is pretty much done as well. We'll come back and touch up the edges underneath once it has dried a few minutes. All right, so we just finished the final coat. We'll allow these to sit for a couple minutes and go outside at our top coat clear. Allow that to rest for a couple hours and then we can go ahead and put this back together.
All right, I'm excited to see it all together as one piece again.
Me too.
Yeah. Well, here's our completed GPU. It looks awesome. You did a great job, Ron. Was there any extra steps?
Yeah, you just want to finish it up by adding a couple coats of clear coat. It does two things for you. It beautifies the paint and also protects the finish. So just spraying a couple light coats over the top, allow it to dry 15 minutes between each coat, mm-hmm. and then the final coat, you probably want it to rest a couple hours before you assemble it all back together.
Okay. Well, it looks great, Ron. Thanks again for coming by.
It's great being here.
Yeah. If you enjoyed seeing these techniques, be sure to subscribe to the channel because on our next episode, we're going to be getting into acrylic tube bending with Lee Harrington of PCJunkieMods.com. Thanks for watching GeForce Garage.